Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I'm going to bring you the another good example of JSP. Now here let I show the demo. A simple this is a simple table. I have to show the records, right? When the page is loaded, very simple example, right? Now here if you enter the relevant ID, click submit button, relevant record should be displayed. Okay, second really display. Otherwise, if you are the first time loader, all the records should be displayed. Okay. Now I am going to enter the another record. I am going to enter the James. Something like that. Salary. I am going to enter as 16,000. Yeah, Kumar. 14,000. Sorry, phone number. Just give something like that. 70,000. Click go. Right, now let's load and see. Here all the things are loaded. Now if you enter the correct, if you enter the searching only the Kumar, you enter the ID for it, relevant record should be displayed. It's simple, right? This is a very simple system I made in JSP, right? So let me see how to do the system step by step, right? So first what I going to do is I'm going to create the project. So how to create the JSP project? Go here, new project, Java web application, click next. Here we have to give the name. So I am going to give employee view. I just give the project name. You can give any name of the project name. I am going to select as Apache Tomcat, right? I am not going to select Glassfish, only Apache Tomcat. It will be support all the SSL certification and everything when you are going to wish to upload on your server, right? So it's best, right? So next, finish, right? Now your project is created successfully here. Now let's delete this one, the default HTML page. Instead of that, I'm going to create the new page as a JSP page, index.jsp page, index only. The extension will be taken automatically. So I'm not going to write the code. So instead of I have all the things I have written, Ctrl C to copy and paste it over here. No, don't worry about that. This all the code I will provide in my website. You will be able to copy and paste, and you can work for the practice purpose. You can work, right? You don't worry about that. It's very simple system. This is only simple form. This only simple. This I have did inside the body. I have designed the simple bootstrap form, right? It's container close div. This is the simple form group. Here I have created a simple form. Okay, here you have a only one field. There will be the employee ID. This EMP ID, this is a field name, right? This is a bootstrap. You have to add the bootstrap. I have already added here bootstrap inside that tag. We have to add that. Those who don't know how to download the bootstrap, you just go to the relevant bootstrap website. You will be able to find it, right? You go to the bootstrap and you can find the this one, right? This link, right? This is the simple one. Okay, it will be available. If you go to the Google, you can just type. You have to go to here. You have to bootstrap. Just go to bootstrap official website. Click on this one. Here you can go to the get started. Here this is CSS. You just copy, and inside the tag you have to paste it. Okay, inside that tag you have to paste it. That's the thing we have did, right? The simple code we have did, paste it. Right click and paste the code, right? That's the thing we have did. You must paste inside that tag, right? After that, this is all simple form design. After that, we have to put one button, submit button. Okay, simple form submit button. We have to put it here. Okay, when you enter the employee ID, click submit button. It goes to the same page, index.jsp page. That means the same page. It will be redirected. Okay, it's not going to. I'm not going to redirect any page. The same page, the record should be displayed. That's why I have put into this code, right? Okay, there how to put in the same code. This one I have separately. We have to write this code, right? We have to, instead of writing like this, I have to put in this code into our above. It should work. It's simple above, right? Okay, now here we have to connect the MySQL connector over here. So we have to download the appropriate driver for that. Then only you will be able to link MySQL database as and our JSP page. So how to link? So you just, you know, those don't know how to connect it, you just go to the MySQL Google, type MySQL connector for Java, click on the first link, here you will be able to download the relevant connector, right? Here this one should be your MySQL connector zip file. You just down click on download button, it will be download the your connector, it will be take you to another website. You no need join or login or sign up, just click no thanks, just my start my download. It will be downloaded here. I don't need to download this time, I already download, so that I just cancel it. What is the things I have downloaded? Go to the, this is your project. Your project consists of web pages folder, source package folder and libraries folder. Select the library folder, right click, add jar folder. Once you are downloaded your MySQL connector first time, it download as a zip file. After extracted, you get it as a normal file, look like this MySQL connector. You download, you just hold on control key down and select this both, open it. Right, that's the stuff you have to do, right? Simple one, you have to do it. Okay, now let's run the application and check, right? So this is a web pages folder, inside here this is a web page, web page, right? So here what I did here is, first we have to implement the MySQL connector connection. Okay, so you have tried the namespace import java.sql. This is the we get sql.all mean you can access all the SQL classes if you write like this. It's a very essential stuff, right? After that, we have to implement the connection object and prepare statement object and RS object. After that, you have to register the MySQL driver, com MySQL driver, MySQL JDBC driver. This is how you register the MySQL driver. I already taught this one. After that, you have to implement the database path, right? Where your database reside on localhost, right? Your database name is M company, which reside on localhost, right? Here localhost which reside, right? Your database name M company, your table name is employee, right? Okay, keep in your mind, this one should be more important. Okay, here before you do this one, you have to import the MySQL connector, then only you will be able to connect the you can access, right? After that, this is the ID. This is coming from when you, this is the ID, okay? This is the text field, input field. When you enter the ID on here, click submit button, it goes to the same page. Here, the same page it goes. It is finding the ID here. The ID should be, it's finding, so that I have to get the ID here. Get the ID and you have to put into here. Get the ID and put into this one. Right, that's the thing we have to do. Put it, get the ID, request parameter, and assign it the relevant variable. That's the thing we have to write. After that, we have to write the out.println for the heading purpose. We have to write here. Heading purpose, we have to write here like this. Click and run file, you can check. Click and run file, you can check here. What's the problem? Right, the problem is here. This one, we have to cut off this one. Select the web pages folder, we have to paste it. I have put it inside this one. That's how it's won't work, right? Inside this one. Okay, the outside you have to put it here. Okay, then only it will be work. Now it's working. Here, now it's working fine. Okay, now it's working fine. Okay, one, right, it's working. Okay. This is the heading. Heading means this is the heading. Sorry, this is the heading. Employee details first time. After that, what I did here is, first you have to check if employee ID null or empty. Why you are putting this condition here? Notice that when you load this page, all the data should be loaded, because if the data is null, okay, if you are not enter anything else for the first time, it is load, it show the all the data, right? So that I have to put it, if the employee ID is not, it is null or empty, will show all the records, right? Select all from employee, RS, we have to create the RS, okay, feed all the data from the database. We have to use the RS method, RS, sorry, result set, this result set class. We have to create the object RS, we have to feed all the data and put it, we have to run it as a SQL, execute query. Here we have to load this one, we have to put it one while condition, and we have to write here, okay, name, phone number and salary. We have to put in the relevant columns, right? This is the thing, table relevant columns, table we have to write here. Table border, BG color, cell padding and cell basic. We have set it like this. Okay. Else, okay, if it is, here if the data is not null, if you enter the ID, any ID, so what happen is, this is not null, this condition is not work. So here, yes, not reset. When the person is enter 1, click submit button, the second condition will be work. It is come here, and second condition is what? Select all from employee, where the ID, what is the ID you entered on this text field. It retrieving here, put into this variable. So you are get it here. So here what is the ID you are there, the matching record should be loaded, and we have to put into this loop, we have to set it here. Okay, the same table, you have to set it here. Okay, this is the thing we have to do. Okay, this is simple stuff, it will be do. Okay, very simple one in JSP. You must try this one. While you are getting any error, you can ask me anytime. This is a good practice for web developers who are want to become a Java web developers. You must practice this one before you have to moving to the Spring Boot. This is the very important stuff. This is the basic stuff you must learn before you are moving to the Spring Boot. Thank you for watching. If you like my channel, you can subscribe me. Subscribe me and like me. Another thing is, we will be uploading more videos on JSP and servlet in our future lesson. Thank you for watching.